Thank you for joining us this morning for the CIS Art Exhibition 2017. I won't even attempt to try and imitate the way of saying the theme of this year's exhibition, the way Mr. J can wax lyrical with the words dynamic, dynamicism, dynamic ignorance, or whatever.
Now you're talking.
But I'm not even going to try and get there, Mr. J. That's your patch. But what I am going to say is thank you for you joining us. Students who are here who are displaying work, it goes beyond thank you. I was desperately thinking this morning of when I did art at school. Two things happened. We learned to paint our hands with the ready-mix white glue, and we let our hands dry and then tried to scare the art teacher by peeling skin off. That was the first event, but then a more even earth-shattering event was when we were let loose with charcoal. And young boys, it was an old boys' school, young boys aged 11, 12, 13, being let loose with something other than crayons. It was a recipe for disaster. We finished the lesson, we looked like we'd been down a coal mine for 18 years. And the matron at the school was very unhappy because our shirts were no longer white. A little bit like yourselves when you come out of our lessons and you've not worn your aprons. But art is a truly, truly wonderful area of not just school life, but life itself. And the one thing that I am so proud of when I look around this hall and when I look in the art room is that it is a representation of your creativity. You know that our school tries to develop everything in everyone. Not just the academic, not just the sport, not just the music, not just the drama, not just the art. We want everything. We want you to experience all that there is. And clearly, it's not just one or two talented young people. It's maybe 222 talented people, who knows. But all I would say to you students is thank you. And really, Mr. J and your team, for allowing them the time and the equipment and the space to develop themselves. I really owe you and your team a huge thank you on that one. Yes. We're going to get started with an official cutting of the ribbon by one of our other guests, Miss Polly. Got the scissors ready. You have to be careful with the scissors, don't we, students? Mariah, can you move the scissors over towards Miss Polly? And I'm going to hand the microphone over to her. Thank you, everybody.
Honoured to be here, and yes, you have to hold your scissors really carefully. Something I always drop into my students is, hold our scissors. So, absolute honour to open this exhibition. Do you want me to talk before or after? I can't do that. Okay, we'll start by opening. Congratulations, everybody.
Do that one, might as well do that one. Hello? There we go.
And it's my absolute honour to be here. If any of you know anything about me, I have got a bit of a passion for education. My background is in teaching and education. And I always say that creativity is the heart of all education. So whether you think you're going to be an artist or a fashion designer, I think creativity needs to be across the board. You can't be a successful lawyer, politician, engineer if you don't have a creative background, if you don't have a creative approach. So I love seeing a school where creativity is fully embraced. I love walking into this space and I see not just art on canvas, but I see these amazing designs made out of old newspapers. I see the design technology going on. I just wish I could see this in more schools in Nigeria, so it's really inspirational to see it here. I just want to say a quick word to the children, because this is all about you. I want you to brace yourself a little bit for the real world. If you're a creative spirit, if you're a, if you have an artistic mind. Creativity and being artistic is a very, very personal thing. You put your whole soul into it. Art is your life. Creativity is your life. It's intensely personal. You can only be successful if you're putting your whole soul and your whole being into that piece of work. Now, when you're in the school environment, you're very protected. You've got your beautiful art teachers who are going to hold your hand and be nice to you. The real world is a tough place. You have to believe in yourself. I want you to remember this exhibition and remember this moment and remember your achievement here and let it stay with you, because the real world can be a bit challenging. The criticisms will come fast and furious. The more you believe in yourself, the more the criticisms will come. Please stand by your guns and believe in yourselves. A lot of people ask me about my inspirations and what drove me to become creative. It's just something I always did. But there were a couple of people that did inspire me when I was quite a young child. And the headmaster of my primary school, as I left that school, he said two words to me. And those two words stay with me to this day. No matter what I'm embarking on, I remember his words. There were two words. And he just took me aside, shook my hand, and whispered in my ear, he said, "Polly, be bold." And those words have stayed with me to this day. So I look at where I am now, I look at the opportunities that come my way, and I remember those two words. So children, please believe in yourself. Be bold. We live once. The opportunities come once. So make the most of it, be bold, embrace it, and believe in yourselves. So well done, all of you.
The theme of the event is expressions of dynamism.
What?
Dynamism. You have to.
Do we all have to say it now?
I would prefer it. It's a. You say that, please. No, let's say the last one. Dynamism. I just want to branch off and quote a lot of what Mr. Mark and Mr. Paul have said. The truth of the matter is this. I am just coming to work, and every day is just like a holiday. The kids are just amazing. The management is amazing. And you parents are just out of sight. So I think you all owe yourself a big round of applause. Because, you know, everybody's just saying, Mr. J. But I'm harassing management, and they are just so dynamic. I'm harassing the kids, they're getting all this stuff. The parents are just, any criticism I'm asking for, I said I want this, the parents are bringing it up. It's just amazing. And so what you see here is a combination of just what Mr. Mark said. It's a family thing. So as in UniWorks, yes, the price tags and everything, but you know, the real thrust is not necessarily the money, but the children and what they put together. When we finish this, we're just going to move over there towards the stage where the junior school kids have a little welcome dance for us. Dance, as a public, is another genre of art, performance art. So the junior school and then since we're going to present. So if you don't mind, we'd just like to move over that way real quick. And that's what we're
doing. Thank you, Mr. J. Thank you.
Thank you. basketball dynamic. Put your hands together for them one more time. And also, put your hands together for the school dance director. Where is Miss Corina? Come over here, come over here. That's her. That's her.
Thank you.
Again, you must say Miss Rogers, brand new. Come here, come here, come here, come here. Yeah.
Hi everybody, my name is Jay Aloney and I'm the head of Department of Art and Design in CIS. We have just been putting up an amazing exhibition on arts in all forms, all genres. We've had performing art, we've got photography, we've got mixed media, we've got paintings. It's just a whole gamut of artistic skill displayed by students of CIS. Why are we doing this? Because we want to showcase talent. Simple, raw talent. And a favorite catchphrase of mine is dynamism. I want to see dynamic art, want to see the children displaying what they have inside. Creativity is the bedrock of success as far as I'm concerned. It will take the kids to so many places. And if you look at those, even people in other professions who are making headway, it's because of the creativity they have within them that's being displayed. That's, you know, my philosophy, and it's been working fantastically. We've been having a great time here, and well, that's what art does. It brings out the best in you, no matter what you're doing. And whether it's fashion, whether it's visual arts, whether it's performing arts, art is art. It's just amazing.
Good morning, my name is Marianne Fakiboboy. I'm in year 9B, and this is my artwork. So art is very important to me. It lets me express myself and let people know who I am. And I don't like almost making work so close to other people's own. So I wanted to be me and express who I am. So this is my artwork. It's called Rolex. I call it Rolex because many people in my class kept doing this dance and this song called Rolex. And there was this guy who made the song. And I thought I should do him. Many people think he's a woman, but it's actually a man. And honestly, if he takes off his mask, he actually does look like a woman. So this is not a woman, it's a man, just so you know. So during my art, I decided to make the mask out of paper because I wanted it to be different. I didn't want to copy anyone. And the hair is made out of cotton wool, and it has it's been spray painted after I painted away with black. So the artist I love to look at that helps me with this kind of designs, with the background cover and everything, is Leonid Afremov. But honestly, if not for that artist, I wouldn't have done this work and I wouldn't have merged it all together. Like, I put the silver with the red and everything. But I love all artists. Even though some have weird art designs, I still think that all artists are really good at art, and I wish one day I could be one of those artists that someone would look up to.
Good morning, my name is Mogbishewa Wilbert and I'm your 9B. I am Deputy House Prefect of Willow House. In my piece, I wanted to represent the fight or flight response in human beings. In the center, you can see a central threat or like unknown figure. And I use different colors to show the different emotions, like red here to show the anger in the fight, and green and blue to show the sadness and despair in the flight. In the art world, I'd say my biggest role model is Pedro Alatiche, because I'm a big fan of her mixed media arts. And I wanted to do that, but in the end, I ended up trying to do my own thing with the painting.
Good morning, my name is Oriofe. I'm in year 9A, and I'm the Deputy House Captain of Sycamore. What art means to me, it's a self-expression, expressionative form. You can either show what you know or what you can know. For my work, what I did is I basically represented the stream and like life forms, the trees, and then the sky, how the sky contrasts with the streams as well.
Good afternoon, my name is Leila Zahereddin and I'm in 10B. And I wanted to talk about my work here that, as you can see. So I basically thought of Nigeria while doing this work. So what I thought of was putting different colors to show that every year more problems are being caused and there is hope that they can be solved. That's why I use glitter, but the government is sort of selfish. So as you can see, if you can zoom in, there's little dots here which also can represent people. So I think that Nigeria does have hope.
Good morning, my name is Jaden Paru and I'm in year 10A at Children's International School. And I'm also the deputy head girl of the senior school. Now this is my artwork and it's titled Mesmerizing. And what it is, it's a reflection of the human reflection in itself. So this side is reflective in the sense that it's sparkly, it's glittery, and it represents a mirror. So it represents you physically looking at yourself. While this side of the face represents the emotions that come with looking at your reflection. So for example, if you feel that, oh, I look good today, you might feel happiness and the flowers blooming represents that happiness. So the process, well, first of all, I painted the hair with acrylic paint and I chose to use a variety of colors to show how wild and exciting and just all over the place your life can be. But I wanted that to be the head to just extend out of the painting to look like it breaches the gap between what is real and what isn't. And also, I used felt for the background and I used some glitter to make this side sparkly and I used tissue paper for the red flowers.
Yeah, my name is Chike Onora, the artist Chike Onora. It's my pleasure to be here at the exhibition, CIS exhibition, as an expression of dynamism. It was a fantastic display of artworks from little kids, and they've done quite well. I like the presentation and the packaging of the works, great, and the content of the work, excellent. Very deep works. I found some very deep people here, like Cheesy, her work cool, very deep, in the deep tones of grey. It's difficult for a child at that age to concentrate on works at that level. Quite interesting. And Deju, some flashy expressions with a play of colors. Interesting. And David Orosanya, David Rapo, fantastic work. These guys are deep. It's a work and perspective coming from the earth and looking upwards. Excellent. And Orosanya's work, deep. A single tree standing all alone, I think it's an extension of an expression of himself that he's trying to put in the work. Quite deep, just reminiscent of the kind of works you see in Van Gogh Museum in Amsterdam. Fantastic, like the late works of Van Gogh on the crows. That's what he did in his job. It's really excellent. And I like the whole concept of letting the children express themselves, feel free to express themselves. You know, that builds their creativity, and no matter what profession they end up with in life, the creativity that they're developing right now would always play a role in their life later. Because I can assure you that some of the best surgeons in the world are the ones who are more creatively inclined. Some of the best bankers are the ones who are more creatively inclined. You can think of new products. Some of the best artists, some of the best architects. like the Burj Dubai or the spinning buildings. Those are people who are very deep into creativity. So I encourage every parent to encourage their children to go into creativity, because it will help them in a long way. Whatever profession they go into, they will come up tip-top. They will come out excellent, and they will triumph over their peers. That's what we're looking forward to. I hope they continue having these kind of exhibitions over and over, because I'll be here to see another one. By God's grace, all the best. Thank you.
Hi, my name is Destiny Fraser. This is CIS, and I'm in year 9. We are having an amazing art exhibition. What does art mean to me? Art means everything to me. It's a way of expressing yourself, whether it's through dance, singing, photography like I do, or painting pictures and drawing. Here's a few of my works. This one is called Queen. I actually use my little sister as a model, and I took a picture of her and then I edited it, played on it and stuff, and everyone's been commenting about it, and I actually did sell one of my works. And then this is another one, it's called Challenge. I was inspired to do it because the picture, when I took it, it made me think of like someone who's going through stress and trying to work their way out of it. So I called it Challenge. And this one is called Atanasia, because it's just, Atanasia means divine. And when I looked at it, I thought of my mom, and that was her name, and the way she struggled and the way she came out of it. Thank you.
Hello, my name is Linda Ogot. I'm a parent at CIS, proud mother to Valerie Ogot in year 8A. I'm standing right beside my daughter's painting, and I'm extremely proud of her. She has just sold this painting for 45,000 naira. Isn't it awesome? This is an abstract of some swans, and you can see the background is very colorful, and it's a very dynamic picture, which goes with the theme. It's all about being dynamic, and I think she nailed it right there. So I'm very happy to be here. There's lots of awesome paintings from the students. You have to get here if you aren't already here. The parents, the students have done some lovely work. I wasn't expecting this. I've been totally blown away by what I'm seeing here. You'd think this is work by some professional, you know, 30 people, their 30s or 40s, or who've had experience of art. You can't believe this is actually work by 14, 15, 16 year olds, and even younger, probably 13, 12. So come one, come all. If you're not down here at CIS, you're missing something great. This is the place to be. Thank you.
Hello, good morning. My name is Ahabwe Bora, and I am a big cousin to Mariah Aneni in year 7A. When she told me that they're having an art exhibition, I didn't expect what I'm seeing here. It's really top notch. I'm not sure the amount of input the teachers and tutors had, but I'm really impressed with what I've seen here today. And when I was a child as well, I used to draw and paint, but I sort of left that for music along the way somehow. But I would definitely encourage my children to do things like this, and I appreciate the school for giving the children an opportunity to do this. Thank you.
Hello, my name is Henri Stolz, and I'm in year 9B. This piece is very important to me, and I think the whole reason why it is because it shows exactly who I am. The name of this piece is Ballerino di Fata. It is Italian for fairy dancer. All of the different elements all emerge into one when you actually understand the meaning. The background is drops of blessings on women. And the reason why I said that is because the inspiration that I got for this is the fairy tale Cinderella, because I like the idea of women being independent without men. The beads is to show all of the different types of women coming together. And the reason why I chose all of the different elements is to show racism, and that I don't like racism at all. Like, I believe that all of these elements came together really well. And this is to show that racism should be cancelled out entirely out of life. Because when we forget about racism, all of us can be happy again. I think my biggest inspiration for this was Mr. J, because I had so many troubles doing this, and he helped me through everything and just got me back on track, and thank you.
Good morning, my name is Isha Mathur, and I'm in year 7, and this is my art piece. The basic inspiration of my work was the rain in Nigeria. I was imagining, what if there were a couple standing in the rain and the rain was colorful? How creative and innovative that would be. So that was my basic inspiration. And then the colors in the art room just inspired me to do something rainbow. So that's my basic inspiration. Thank you.
Hello. Well, I'm very impressed by the artwork that all the children have put together. I actually find it surprising that they have the time in the midst of all their academic work to be able to do such, for lack of a better word, inspirational art. I see pictures, photography, abstract art. I see collages. I'm surprised even the children from year two are participating in this event. And I think it's simply wonderful.
Hello, my name is Faith Umenyi, and I've been a guest at the art exhibition here at CIS. And I must say it's amazing. You see the things that the kids have done, the paper mache, the sculptures, everything is amazing. If my child would venture into art, I would definitely encourage him.
Good afternoon, my name is Hosna Senusi. I'm in year nine. I was inspired by the community that I live in, because where I live around, many people wear hijabs and niqabs, and I just wanted to make a statement because I know the things going on in the world about how women are hiding behind their hijabs. So it was initially going to be called The Woman Behind the Hijab, to show there is a person behind what they're wearing. So that's basically where I got my inspiration.
Hello, my name is Tiwa Ladumoye, and I'm in year nine. I'm in love with photography. It's something that I find comes easy to me and that I enjoy doing. What made me fall in love with photography was being able to see everything clearly again, because I didn't have glasses previously. So when I didn't, I was able to notice the lines on the floor or the patterns on a wall. That was what made me fall in love with photography, because I realized I could create that same happiness I felt when I was able to see the smaller details and things with a camera. And I love being able to pick on the little things that make everything unique, because I believe there is beauty in everything, and that photography allows you to do that. For example, this is my sister, and this picture was something that came easy because I was trying to express the emotion that she felt, which is where I showed the contrast between the different sides. So photography is something I genuinely love.
My name is Michael Ikpoki. My son is David Ikpoki. He's in class 7C. I've spent a bit of time looking around. I'm not exactly an art expert, but I can identify creativity when I see it. And what I'm seeing here is pretty amazing. And really, speaking to the students, I think the big takeaway for me is they're very clear about the concepts, they're very clear about the messages they're trying to convey, and it's such beautiful work from such young, creative minds. So I'm really quite excited. I think that art is a very important part of our economy. Creativity is an important part of our economy. And I think it's great that we're encouraging our students, our children, to be as creative as they can be. And this is really mind-blowing. I'm quite excited.
Hello, my name is Jeremy Wilbert. I'm mom to Isha and Tosan Wilbert in the year 7 and year 9, respectively. And I think this is amazing. I'll be really honest with you, when my kids kept talking about the art program, I sort of brushed them off because I just thought, you know what, a few little paintings on the wall and that's it. But this is amazing. I mean, I've been so impressed with the work done by the kids. I've seen some really awesome pictures and paintings. And even over on the DT section, the children's clocks, I just finished looking at that one now, and I'm blown away. That's just it. I'm blown away. I can't believe this is done by the kids. And I'm really proud of the children, and I hope that the school will encourage them, and if possible, make this an annual event, because this is amazing.
Good morning, my name is Mariah Nani. I'm in year 7A, and I want to show about my work, and it's called Falling for Love. It's about this woman who is falling. The heart stands for the love, and when you're in love, you think you're always in the sky and you're always dazing. And because the sun in general is very big, and all she really needs is love, and that's why I made it. What inspired me at first was I thought of one of the main things that we need on Earth and how this world can become a better place. And I mostly thought of the conversation between people and how they normally used to hate each other. So I thought that maybe if I do the opposite of friendliness, like friendliness, kindness, love, caring, it will inspire me. And I did something based on that. Thank you.
Hello. I'm Jennifer McAntonis, parent to Daphne McAntonis. I'm happy to be here today with the artwork exhibition. This is awesome, it's great, it's beautiful. I'm happy to see and I'm inspired to see the hard work of the children.
My name is Nneka Davis Okundaye, the owner of Nneka Art Gallery. I was invited by the school to come and see this exhibition. And I have to thank the organizer and thank the school for allowing the children to create what is in their mind. And I would love the Lagos State to make a package for any of these children who really have the creativity in them, to allow them to be able to have a get together once in a year so they can bring first, second and third, and also to encourage the other younger one and any other school that is not encouraged, so they can continue to create more and more, because art is bigger than oil and art can be sold anywhere in the world. Their work has what international standard, because when you look at the prices, it's priceless. The energy, the time they have used to create this work, when you look at the work, you feel the joy, and you can see the joy in the faces of the children. So I would love the government to encourage them, maybe even help the school with some art material so they can come up with a bigger idea in the next exhibition.
My name is Okiemuti Obore. I teach in CIS Art and Design. Expression of Dynamism is an exhibition that we are holding for 2017. It's a joint exhibition between the senior school and the junior school. And also, we're also doing an exhibition for the design and tech department. Now, everything you see here today is an expression of what the students have come up with. Well, it wasn't easy putting up this exhibition with the students. You know the way children are.
Good afternoon. I'm here at the art exhibition, and my name is Ovota Iyamu, and I'm on the advisory board of CIS. This is very impressive. This is a great body of works. You know, the children have, looks like they've given their hearts, you know, to this, and I'm very, very impressed. I think this should even just be showcased in other galleries, because lots and lots of great works. I've seen pictures, I've seen, you know, oil on canvas, I've seen different medium being used, and it's very impressive. I want to congratulate all the children that just did all this, and the teachers that supported them. I was talking to one of the young students, and I was asking how he decided on what to do. And even the explanation of what he did and his concept was quite interesting, you know, about the cycle of life and how he felt like, you know, we do the same things over and over again. And that concept translated to his art. I'm very, very impressed, you know. They have a long way to go, but they're there already and they're on the way. I'm very impressed. Thank you.
Good afternoon. My name is Joke Chukuma, founder of Children's International School. And we're here to watch the exhibition of our secondary school students. I must say that I'm extremely impressed by the quality of the work, the way they've been able to express themselves through creativity, through art. And I think it's something that every school should encourage, because not all our kids can be accountants or lawyers or doctors. I think it's a way of untapping their talents, their hidden talents. Kids are able to express themselves in such a way that they can even earn a living from their talents. So I think it's something we should all encourage. And it's really, really worth it.